Good morning. Welcome back to my travel channel, Travel Diaries Odisha. Today I am going to take you to a small town called Dharakot in Ganjam district. Dharakot was once a princely state or Gorja state, what we call in Odia. Dharakot has, you find a 18th century Jagannath temple, which is of course not remarkable architecturally, but what makes this temple unique for its murals and the frescoes which you find in the interior of the temples, which were executed in early 19th century. So these murals of Jagannath temple revolve around the cult of Vaishnavism. So when we talk about murals, heritage of murals or frescoes in Odisha, Odisha doesn't figure anywhere when it is compared with states like Karnataka or Andhra Pradesh or Tamil Nadu, Maharashtra, Rajasthan, Gujarat. Odisha doesn't figure anywhere when we talk about the mural heritage. But it doesn't mean that Odisha did not have any mural heritage. Odisha had a flourishing tradition of murals or the frescoes, which you find right from the very beginning of human civilizations. Not human civilizations, even in the prehistoric times. So when we go to the caves, the natural caves of Sundargarh district or Kalahandi districts in western part of Odisha, you find execution of murals. And these murals go back to the prehistoric time. And in Bhubaneswar region, the Bhubaneswar metropolitan regions, you have so many natural caves. The famous one being the Khandagiri and Udayagiri caves. Here also you find the depiction of, murals going back to the prehistoric times. For example, at Hathigumpha caves, you find a depiction of a couple in red ochre color going back to 4,000 years before. Then you have the famous Sitabinji archaeological site in Keunjhar district in northern Odisha, where you have depiction in Gupta period, not in Gupta period, post-Gupta period, a depiction of a royal processions. And this makes how Odisha was known to outsiders for its rich mural heritage. Then in 12th century AD, from 12th century AD onwards, Odisha became a major center of Jagannath cult. It became a hub of Vaishnava center. It became a hub of Vishnu worship. So in Puri, the Jagannath Dham Puri, you have different mutts, and then there are several villages where Chitrakaras were commissioned to execute paintings on walls, which we find in some of the, monasteries, Hindu monasteries, mutts in Puri. But it was Ganjam which took actually the lead when we talk about the murals. You must be knowing about the Biranchi Narayan temple at Buguda, which actually marked the beginning of experimenting of murals, again combining with South India and Puri styles, which we'll be seeing in these presentations. And then Dharakot in Jagannath temple evolved from Biranchi Narayan temple. It was influenced by Biranchi Narayan temple murals, and it evolved into a major center of mural productions, wall murals or fresco productions. And you find a range of murals, all revolving around the Vishnu or Jagannath cult. So let's go through this presentation. Thank you so much.
Raja Sri Karbhanja, in Indian history or even Odisha history, he does not figure anywhere. Why would be he? He had not fought a single war, nor did that he rule a large territory. However, many few would know that Raja Sri Karbhanja had silently brought in a revolution in the art landscape of Odisha. He was a great devotee of Lord Rama. Towards the end of the 18th century, because of some family dispute, he had been sent to South India in exile. Wandering in South India, his devotion to Lord Rama and inclination for art, especially murals, had brought him to many splendors of South Indian palaces and temples, filled with frescoes and murals from Vijayanagara and Nayaka periods. He drew ideas subconsciously in his mind upon returning to his hometown Gumsar, now Bhanjanagar. He was made again the king in 1819. Once started a fresh reign, Sri Kara took initiatives to experiment with his yearning for his beloved Gumsar. A major project was the construction of a wooden and stone temple for Lord Biranchi Narayana, temple at Buguda, 25 km from his capital. The Buguda experiment initiated a new chapter in the history of art in Odisha, which until now had mostly focused on stone carvings. Influenced by the murals of Biranchi Narayan temple, several kings in the neighboring kingdoms like Parlakhemundi, Sanakhemundi, Chikiti, and Dharakota also started experimenting with murals in their respective territories. Over time, the region of Ganjam was established as a major center of murals of fresco paintings, where one finds a unique blend of South Indian and Puri styles. The style in Ganjam came to be known as Dakshini. Today, the Dakshini murals of Ganjam have been faded against time, except the Jagannath temple at Dharakota, which has retained some of its priceless murals. In Odisha, Puri was the major center for Odia Chitrakaras, whose work was connected with the Jagannath temple. Some of them moved to various Sasana Brahmin villages around Puri to work for their Brahmin patrons. During the 18th century, secondary Jagannath temples were built in feudatory Gurjat states of Odisha. Chitrakaras were sent out to provide replacement images and perform other services to temples. The state of Dharakot, located in the heart of Ganjam near the town of Aska, had also drawn a few Chitrakaras to illustrate the interiors of the Jagannath temple. The theme of the murals are aspects of Lord Vishnu, his incarnations, events in his life, and Lord Jagannath. Together with the depiction of Lord Vishnu's narratives, the Chitrakaras also drew landscapes, animals, and birds, floral motifs, royal ladies, and many more in rich and vibrant colors. The backgrounds of panels are either white or earth colors filled with minor characters and semi-divine deities. The Jagannath temple at Dharakot had been built during the rule of Raja Jai Singh between 1732 and 1758. However, the mural work was commissioned much later in the early 19th century during the reign of Raja Jagannath Singh. While the Buguda murals have an exceptional aspect, the subdued earthy palette at Dharakot, one finds the use of a vibrant color palette, blue being a prominent color which is mostly used to depict Lord Vishnu and his incarnations. Besides blue, dark brown, off-white, shades of red and earth colors are also well represented. Some of Dharakot's well represented murals are Narasimha Avatar, Anantashayi Vishnu, Navagunjara, Bhaman Avatar, Mathura Vijaya and Lord Jagannath. While central themes of the panels are well highlighted, covering large areas, the surrounding are filled with the associated stories depicting characters and their performances. Most of the characters are adorned with royal and exotic costumes of the period. The large size depictions of royal women are a special attraction of Dharakot Jagannath Temple. They transport your mind to the period of monarchical rule in Ganjam, where opulent wealth and high status marked the royal life in the days of yore. The conical ceiling of the temple is filled with rows of tiny characters representing acrobats, birds, dancers, musicians, fortune tellers, courtesans, priests, and minor Hindu gods and goddesses. They, together with animals like deer, tiger, elephants, and birds like swans, parrots, and foliage, form a visual treat to eyes. When compared with the murals of Buguda, the Dharakot murals are found more subtle, vibrant and diverse in color schemes and depiction of ideas. There is a lot of humility and humbleness in their depictions. They are undoubtedly Ganjam's Ajanta and Lepakshi, widely known among art connoisseurs as mural capitals of India.